गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल द रिस्पेक्टेड जूरी मेंबर्स एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हु आर लिसनिंग। मायसेल्फ शारिक हुसैन, आई एम पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट फ्रॉम द बुंदेलखंड यूनिवर्सिटी झांसी एंड आई एम हियर टू प्रेजेंट माई टॉपिक नेम कंपैरेटिव स्टडी ऑन डिफरेंट बफर्स यूज इन फॉरेंसिक डीएनए एनालिसिस फॉर ऑब्जर्विंग देयर लाइसिस पोटेंशियल। या एज वी ऑल नो एवरी लिविंग क्रिएचर इज जेनेटिकली डिफरेंट ऑन इट्स वे एक्सेप्ट फॉर द आइडेंटिकल ट्विन्स ट्रिप्लेट्स एक्सेट्रा। DNA is a comparable to the serial number for pubic things. Each individual contains a unique sequence that is specific to that one organism. Unlike the traditional fingerprints, which can be surgically altered or self-mutilated, but the DNA sequence cannot easily be changed once the material is left at a crime scene. So this will increase its effectiveness in forensics and the probability of finding an exact match. And as we know, in criminal justice system, the technique is highly appreciated in solving the cases of many assortments such as paternity disputes, missing person identification, identification of the mutilated bodies, sexual assault cases, and the identification of the origin of trace biological materials found in the crime scene. As we all know, DNA fingerprinting was invented in 1984 by the professor Sir Alec Jeffrey. But we cannot forget in India, DNA fingerprinting has started by Dr. Lalji Singh. Lalji Singh is also known as the father of being printing in India due to the lifetime contribution for the development and establishment of indigenous DNA fingerprinting technology in India. His contribution of DNA fingerprinting first came into the field of forensic science and the judiciary system when he took the paternity case of Kuniraman versus Manoj. So this is the first case where the evidence by the DNA that test has been accepted by the Honorable Court of Kerala. Next one is steps involved in the DNA sample processing. Here are some steps which are involved in DNA sample processing. First upon, DNA is isolated within the nucleus of a cell throughout the body, and the extraction step is responsible for breaking the nucleus and releasing the DNA molecules into the solution. We have to ensure that the DNA record from extraction is human rather than from another source such as bacteria. So therefore, the quantitation process necessary. This is done through quantitation, where the quality and the quantity of the DNA present in a sample is measured and assessed. Additionally, determining the amount of DNA sample is essential for the success in the next step, since the amplification system requires a narrow range of input DNA. Third one is amplification, where the amplification is accomplished through the use of technique known as polymerase chain reaction. PCR is a process in which the millions of the copies of specific sequence of DNA can be made in a matter of only few hours. This is important for the forensic DNA samples, since the DNA found at a crime scene is limited in both the quantity and quality. So it is basically known as the molecular xeroxing process. Next one is capillary electrophoresis. For that, the PCR reaction is completed and result with a large number of amplified DNA molecules. And there are the various extraction methods. That is the organic and inorganic extraction methods. Inorganic, the phenol chloroform is a popular method we use for the DNA extraction. And in inorganic methods, the silica gel based and the salting on methods are popular. And also the shellless extraction, solid phase extraction, and the differential extraction protocols are also used. Next. So here is the introduction, also the objective of the study. As we know, blood stains are considered to be the most commonly traced biological evidence present in a crime scene. While processing for the DNA profiling of the forensic evidences, the DNA extraction is the primary process. Isolation of DNA from the blood in adequate quantities is an integral part of the forensic analysis. While whole blood samples are one of the main sources used to obtain the DNA, and there are many different protocols available to perform the nucleic acid extraction, means the different extraction methods yield different amount of DNA with varying levels of purity and quantity also. So we have to discuss over here previous place. In India, due to the lack of manpower and pendency of the cases, the DNA extraction cannot always be performed at the time of sample collection. Therefore, the whole blood samples may be stored for years before being processed. Long-term storage of the whole blood can affect the integrity of the DNA if it is not done under the optimal condition. So blood samples stored at a 4 degree Celsius for a shorter period of time will still yield DNA of the acceptable quantity. But the blood samples which are stored for a longer period of the time show some degradable changes. As we know, the presence of the ADTA as an anticoagulant resulted in the high yield of the good quality DNA, which is also in sometimes the degraded samples due to additionally biochemical changes occurs in the blood after long storage, such as decrease in pH, changes in the blood gases, alternations in the contents of amino acids, carbohydrates, and also the lipids and cofactors, which might further influence the cell viability. So here in chloroform extraction method, the mainly used here in this study, we use the chloroform extraction method. In this chloroform extraction method, the mainly used buffer is forensic buffer, but here we use another buffer named MPD buffer, which is a unique buffer and only used in the DNA division SFL Sagar. So we compare the new buffer, that is MPDB, with the other two buffers by using the phenol chloroform extraction method. So here are the materials we require. The samples, there were total 68 numbers of blood samples were taken for this study. All the blood samples are collected from the healthy individuals. There were 50 were the 3-month-old blood samples, 45 were the 6-month-old blood samples, and 8 were the fresh blood samples were taken for the study. The ethical plasma was obtained. A list of the instruments which are used and the material which are used are as shown. Next, please. These are the buffers which we use on a study. Forensic buffer, MPDB buffer. The contents are undisclosed because this is under patent by the Dr. Pankaj Srivastava sir. And the further studies are going on with this buffer, so we cannot disclose the content of it. So please, next. These are the chemicals which we used. And next, please. These are the steps involved in the extraction. That is, first upon, we take a blood sample, the blood sample in which the tissues must be first lysed with a specific solution like LGS. Buffers are mixed with the EDTA as a chelating substance. In the next step, phenol chloroform, isoamyl alcohol, then denature the proteins. The spin yields of the upper aqueous layer containing DNA and the organic layer containing the precipitated proteins. To remove the precipitated protein, extraction must be continued and high concentration of salt is used. And next, the washes of this ethanol precipitated DNA, and then the sample is resuspended in a suitable reagent containing EDTA. So first upon, we take a sample, we take a fresh blood sample, then we made 3 replicas of 100 microliter each. Then the phenol chloroform extraction method with forensic buffer. Then we go for the MPDB, and also we go for the SCB buffer. Here, next, please. Yeah, next. This is the procedure. Then after the extraction, the DNA samples were quantified to check the yield of DNA present in a particular sample. Then the quantitation was done by the Cuvit 2.2 fluorometer, in which we use the HS buffer and the particular dye. And the sample, the extracted DNA samples were introduced, and then we get the particular yield of a sample. Next, please. So yes, these are the results. These are the results in which we get the average yield in fresh blood samples. Also, the average yield was higher in MPDB buffer. And next, please. Also, in the 3-month-old blood sample, we get a higher yield MPDB buffer rather than the standard buffer which we use in the phenol chloroform extraction method. And also, we get the higher yield than the standard extraction buffer. Next, please. Also, in the 6-month-old blood samples, yet the yield is low, but the yield is greater than both the standard buffer, that is forensic buffer and SCV buffer. Next, please. In the statistical analysis, we use the ANOVA to determine the significant differences between the means of 3 or more independent groups. This statistical analysis was done by using GraphPad Prism 5 software, and also we used the Bonferroni multiple comparison test to show the significant differences between all the data and all the buffers we use, and we get the protocol resulted in the average yield of DNA in fresh blood sample, that is 20.6. and 12.2 in 3-month-old blood samples and 1.84 in the 6-month-old blood samples, respectively, which are lies in the MPDB buffer. And as we know that this buffer, MPDB buffer, gave a higher yield compared to the other buffers. Next, please. Yeah, so this is the due to the less space, I did not include all the data tables over here. But this is the final LOR table of the Bonferri multiple comparison test. This mean value obtained in the final LTOPA shows that significant results in the two different buffers rather than the standard buffer, which is commonly used in forensic DNA analysis. The forensic buffer, which give minimum yield in all the three different ranges of the blood samples, sometimes give the similar results like the stain extraction buffer, but not more than the MPD buffer. So here we got the more yield in MPD buffer regarding with forensic buffer, but in case of MPD buffer with respect to of stain extraction buffer, we got same amount of DNA. Next, please. Yeah, so move on our conclusion part. The most commonly used buffer, which is a forensic buffer, is tested for its efficiency towards the lysis of range of blood samples. Here we use the 3 month old fresh blood sample and 6 month old blood samples with to check the lysis potential of two other buffers, which is MPTB and SEB. But the result showed that the MPTB gave efficient results than the forensic buffer. So by using the MPTB as a buffer in fluoroform extraction method, organic extraction method, we get the amount of DNA which is higher than the other two buffer, which is forensic buffer and stain extraction buffer. And also we come to know that the MPTB can be used as the base buffer in fluoroform extraction method. From this finding, it can be concluded that all the MPTB shows the better lysis potential and efficient regarding with two other buffers. So we can use this new buffer for further studies also. Yeah, thank you so much.